Welcome to session 3. Myself Jalaja Sajeev, PGT Bio from Kendriya Vidyalaya Keshapuram. I have already given one question to think and answer to you in the previous session. I think you are ready. Now see the question. A pea plant producing axial flower is crossed with another pea plant producing terminal flower. Among the progenies, 45 plants are producing axial flower, whereas 48 plants are producing terminal flower. So, here we are considering only one pair of contrasting character. So, it is an example of a monohybrid cross. The character here is axial flower and the other is terminal flower. Now, already we have discussed about the characters, contrasting pairs of characters, which one is dominant and which one is recessive. As you know that axial flower, it is dominant, whereas terminal flower is recessive. Now, among the progenies, by crossing these two plants, 45 plants are producing axial flower, whereas 48 plants are producing terminal flower. Here the question is, what is the type of inheritance noticed here? Since these two ratios, see the number 45 axial and 48 terminal, these two are almost appearing in equal proportion, that is 1:1 ratio. So, this particular cross is an example of test cross. And now, we know that in test cross, one individual will be definitely heterozygous and the other will be recessive parent. So, here the heterozygous individual will be axial, the plant that produces axial flower. So, here is the question, what is the type of inheritance noticed here? The answer is, it is a test cross, monohybrid test cross. Since the progenies are appearing in almost equal proportion, 1:1 ratio, it is a monohybrid test cross. And here the genotypes of the parents are axial, that will be heterozygous, terminal, that is homozygous. Now, we can work out this cross using Punnett square. Listen, parents, again male into female, phenotypes, we can consider axial as male and terminal as female. Now comes genotype. Capital A and small a. Why it is written capital A small a? Because it is a test cross where the dominant parent will be heterozygous. And we know that the terminal one, it is a recessive character. So, it will be always homozygous, small a, small a. Now, coming to gametes, capital A small a, and here it is small a gametes. Now we have to show this union of gametes and production of progenies using the Punnett's square. Here we will write the female gamete small a, and here also small a. This is capital A, here it is small a. Now see the union, capital A and small a will come here. This is also the same capital A small a combination. Here we will get to the small a small a, and these two also produces small a small a. Now analyze the phenotype. Here you can see two individuals are axial, that means producing axial flower, and two are terminal, that means again 1:1 ratio. So this particular cross, it is an example of a test cross. So here comes the full answer of your question. Now we can move to the next concept, that is dihybrid cross. As you already know, monohybrid cross, its phenotype, genotypic ratios, test cross ratio, etc. Once again I am repeating, monohybrid cross between two parents differing in one pair of contrasting characters. And the phenotypic ratio in a monohybrid cross is 3:1, and the genotypic ratio in a monohybrid cross is 1:2, 2:1. The test cross ratio in a monohybrid cross is 1:1, and in back cross we will get only dominant phenotype. Now coming to the dihybrid cross, di means two. Dihybrid cross is a cross involving two parents differing in two pairs of contrasting characters. You can see di means two. Here two pairs of contrasting characters are involved. The cross between two parents differing in two pairs of contrasting characters, that is called as dihybrid cross. For example, a Mendel selected two characters at a time and studied its inheritance. First character, for example, shape of the seed or form of the seed, and the second character is color of the seed or color of cotyledon also we can say. So here shape of the seed, we know that the contrasting characters are round and wrinkled. Color of the seed, the contrasting characters are yellow and green. Now coming to Mendel's experiment for dihybrid cross, first selection of pure breeding pea plants or true breeding pea plants, and ensure that they are homozygous, and for this purpose there is the continuous self pollination. So Mendel selected here a plant producing a round seed and yellow cotyledon, and the other one wrinkled seed and green cotyledon. So round yellow is crossed with a ringled green. As we know that before this crossing, hybridization, selection of parent, then bagging of the flowers to avoid contamination with foreign pollens, then collect the pollen grains and dust it on the stigma of the female plant. Here comes again the emasculation. Female plant, or for producing a female flower or female plant, there needs the process emasculation. The ringled green plant is emasculated and converted into female plant, and the male plant, that is round and yellow. So, collected the pollen grain from round yellow plant and dusted on the stigma of the female plant, that is the plant producing ringled and green seeds. Now, after cross pollination or hybridization also, there is the need for bagging to avoid contamination with foreign pollen grains. When the seeds become mature, collected the seeds and sown the seeds to produce the F1 hybrids. And here all the F1 hybrids were round yellow in phenotype. In the next step, there is the production of F2 generation by selfing of the F1 hybrid progenies. Mendel observed 9 progenies are round yellow in phenotype, 3 progenies round green, 3 progenies ringled yellow and 1 is ringled green. That means out of the 16 progenies, 9 by 16 are producing round and yellow seeds, 3 by 16 are producing round and green seeds. 3 by 16 of the F2 progenies are producing ringled and yellow seed, and see, the 1 by 16 of the F2 progenies produces ringled and green seeds. So, here the F2 phenotypic ratio of a dihybrid cross is 9:3:3:1. The genotypic ratio is 1:2:2:1, 2:4:2, and 1:2:1. We can show this cross by genetic symbolization using Punnett square. Listen. Parents, we will consider as male and female, phenotype male plant is producing a round seed with yellow cotyledon. Or female plant is producing wrinkled seed with a green cotyledon. Round is dominant over wrinkled. Yellow is dominant over green. Now the next step, we have to write the genotype of the progenies, genotype of the parents. Round, we will use the letter R. So capital R, capital R. And for yellow, we will use Y, capital Y, capital Y. Here it is homozygous for both the pairs of alleles. Because it is a true breeding or pure breeding plant. Wrinkled one, since it is a recessive character, we will represent it by using small r, smaller, smaller. Green is also a recessive character, so we will use the letter small y here. Now comes the production of gametes. The allelic pairs present in this individual during gamete formation segregate and move to different gametes. The separation of the first pair of alleles is independent from the separation of the second pair of alleles, and the assorted alleles, the separated alleles, they assort at random, producing four different types of gametes. So this is the concept and the conclusion that we will learn in law of independent assortment. So here these two alleles, they are separating, so capital R, then capital Y, one gamete. The other is capital R, capital Y, another gamete. Here it is small r, small y, small r, small y. In the gamete, there will be one allele for each character. So here is the production of capital R and capital Y gamete. Here is the production of small r and small y gamete. Now cross pollination, crossing, there is the production of F1 hybrid, capital R, then we have to write the alternative letter small r, capital Y, then small y. This is the F1 dihybrid, F1 generation, and it is heterozygous for two pairs of alleles. First pair capital R small r, second pair capital Y small y. So it is a dihybrid. Now coming to the phenotype of this one. Capital R allele is dominant over small r allele, capital Y allele is dominant over small y allele. So it is again round yellow, round yellow in phenotype. Now in the next step, there is the production of F2 generation by selfing of this F1 dihybrid. Selfing of F1 dihybrid. Capital R small r, capital Y small y into capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. Here also one parent we will consider as male and the other one as female. Now, the different types of gametes, listen how the gametes are produced. Capital R allele can combine with capital Y allele. Similarly, capital R can combines with small y. Then there is the next allele small r, it can combines with capital Y, and small r can combines with small y. So, one dihybrid individual produces four different types of gametes. Separation of one pair of allele is independent from the separation of the second pair of allele. Here the separation of a capital R and small r alleles are totally independent from the separation of the second pair of allele capital Y and small y. Separated or segregated alleles unite at random and producing these four different types of gametes, such as you can see here capital R, capital Y, capital R and small y, small r and capital Y, small r, small y. So, these are the gametes produced by an F1 dihybrid. Then the second parent that will also produces the same gamete, four different types, capital R, capital Y gamete, capital R and small y gamete, small r capital Y gamete, small r small y gamete. This produced by the female parent. Now, we can represent these gametes in a Punnett square. Female gamete, for example, capital R, capital Y, capital R and small y, small r, capital Y and small r, small y. Here we will write the male gamete, capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, small r, small y. Like this, you can write the gametes, four gametes on the top horizontal side, that is the female gamete, four gametes on the left hand side, that is on the vertical side, the male gametes. Now, their union, union of these gametes. Listen how it can be written: capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. Second one, capital R, capital R, capital Y, small y. First a capital letter, then followed by small letters. Here it is capital R first, followed by small r, capital Y, capital Y, like this. This combination will be capital R and small r, capital Y, small y. Now, here it is capital R, capital R, capital Y and small y. This capital R, capital R and both are small y. Here it is capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. This is capital R and small r, small y, small y. Capital R, small r, capital Y, again capital Y. Capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. See this combination. Like this. Small r, and capital Y here. Small r, capital Y, small y. This one is capital R, capital Y, small y. Here see, capital R, small y, small y. This is small r, and cap and capital Y, small y. This will be double recessive, small r, small y. So, when you are observing this F2, Punnett square, you can see 16 different types of genotypes, genetic combinations here, 16 progenies with 16 different genotypes. And see how many different phenotypes are available here. First one, this is round and yellow. See what is the phenotype of this individual? It is again round yellow. This will also round yellow because R is dominant over small r and capital Y for yellow. This is round yellow. This one also round yellow. This is round and green. This is round yellow. Round green. This one round yellow. Again round yellow. This is wrinkled yellow. This is also wrinkled yellow because wrinkled one, that is controlled by small r gene, recessive gene. Round yellow. This one is again round and green. This is wrinkled yellow. This is wrinkled and green. So, when you analyze here in this F2 generation, 16 different genotypes and 4 different types of phenotypes you can hear. Now, what are the phenotypes that you have observed here? Round yellow. Round yellow, then next one is round green, then wrinkled yellow, now the last one, that is wrinkled green. So, there are 4 different types of phenotypes. Now, count the number of round yellow progenies here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So, round yellow you will get 9 individuals. Now comes to round green, 1, 2 and 3. So, round green is equal to 3. Now comes to wrinkled yellow, 1, 2 and 3. Wrinkled yellow is also 3. Now comes to wrinkled green. Only one is available here. So from this F2 generation, you can see round yellow progeny is 9 out of 16. Round green progeny is 3 out of 16. Wrinkled yellow again 3 out of 16. And wrinkled green 1 out of 16. So, the phenotypic ratio of an F2 dihybrid cross. Phenotypic ratio of an F2 dihybrid cross is 9:3:3:1. Now comes to the genotypic ratio. The genotypic ratio is 1:2:2:1. Then it's double. That is 2:4:2. Again half. 1:2:2:1. So it is easy for you to memorize the phenotypic as well as genotypic ratio of a dihybrid cross. 1:2:2:1 on either side. You can see here on either side there is 1:2:2:1. What is this 1:2:2:1? 1:2:2:1, you know it is the genotypic ratio of a monohybrid cross. So that 1:2:2:1 you can write on either side. Then it's double, that is 2:4:2 at the center. So this, in this way you can memorize it easily. 1:2:2:1, 2:4:2 and 1:2:2:1. So this is regarding the phenotypic as well as genotypic ratio of a dihybrid cross. Now we can move to the test cross, dihybrid test cross. So, as we have already listened that test cross is crossing of an F1 hybrid back to its recessive parent, or the crossing of an individual whose genotype is unknown with its recessive parent in order to identify the genotype. As we all know that in the monohybrid test cross the ratio is 1:1. Here it is 1:1:1:1. So, if the progenies are appearing in 1:1:1:1 ratio, then the genotype of the unknown individual will be heterozygous. Here it is heterozygous for 2 pairs of contrasting characters. Now, the cross can be shown here. As we know that this is the F1 dihybrid with 2 pairs of contrasting character, they are heterozygous for both the pairs of alleles, and this F1 hybrid is crossed back to its recessive parent. See the explanation here. F1 hybrid, that is capital T, capital R small r, capital Y small y. This is the F1 hybrid that produced in this particular cross here. It is crossed with small r, small y. Here the phenotype is round yellow, crossed with wrinkled green. Gametes, four different types of gametes are produced here, like this, capital R and capital Y, capital R small y, small r capital Y, and small r small y. Here only one type of gamete is produced, small r small y. The other is also same, small r small y. Now we can represent it in the form of a Punnett square here. Suppose we are taking this as female and this as, this one is male and this one is female. The combination we will show like this in the Punnett square, male gametes capital R capital Y, capital R small y, small r capital Y, and small r small y. Female gamete small r small y, here also small r small y, capital R capital Y small y, capital R small r capital Y small y here, capital R small y small y, capital R small y small y. This both are small r capital Y small y, this will be small r and capital Y small y, small r, small y, small y, and small r, small y, small y. So, here the phenotype obtained will be round yellow, round green, wrinkled yellow, and wrinkled green. So, again here there is four phenotype. Round yellow, round and green, wrinkled and yellow. This is wrinkled and green. Now count the numbers. Round yellow 2, round green again 2, wrinkled yellow will be 2 and wrinkled green is also 2. What it means? All the progenies are appearing in equal proportion, that is they are appearing in an 1:1 ratio. See here, 1:1 ratio. This is the monohybrid, dihybrid test cross ratio, dihybrid test cross ratio, that is 1:1:1. 1:1. Now come to the dihybrid of Bacrose. Crossing of F1 dihybrid back to its dominant parent. F1 dihybrid in this particular cross is capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, and the dominant parent is capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. This is round yellow in phenotype that is taken as male, and here it is round and this is also yellow in phenotype. But this is the F1 dihybrid. Consider it as female. Gametes capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, and small r, small y. See here, female gamete. Male gamete, capital R and capital Y, capital R and capital Y. This will be the combination like this, capital R and capital Y, small y here, capital R, small r, capital Y, capital Y. See this combination, these two. Capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. Capital R, capital R and capital Y, small y. Capital R, small r, capital Y, capital Y. Capital Y and small y. Now see the phenotype. What phenotype you are getting in this cross? This is round and yellow. Again round yellow. This is also round yellow. This one round yellow in phenotype, round yellow in phenotype, round yellow here, this also round yellow and round yellow in phenotype. What an amazing result it is. All the phenotypes, all the progenies are round yellow in phenotype. We know that round yellow is the dominant character. So it comes to the conclusion that in a Bacrose, all the progenies obtained will be dominant in phenotype. But what about Tuscrose? We will get 4 different phenotypes in equal proportion, that means in 1:1:1:1 ratio, that is the difference. Now it is the time for the review questions. Here is the review question for you. When a cross is made between tall plant with yellow seed, see the genotype. It is heterozygous for both the pairs of alleles. So it is a F1 dihybrid. And tall plant with green seed. Tall plant, heterozygous tall, heterozygous for one pair of alleles, and green seed, that is homozygous recessive character. What proportions of phenotype in the offspring could be expected to be tall and green? After this particular cross, how many progenies will be tall and green, and how many will be dwarf and green? That we have to work out. So, see the answer. Tall yellow into tall green. This is the question that is given in your, given to you. First plant is tall and yellow, the other is tall and green. Genotype is already given here. Tall yellow is heterozygous and tall green is heterozygous for one pair of alleles. Now, come to the gametes. Capital T and capital Y, capital T, small y, small t, capital Y, and small t, small y. These are the four gametes. Suppose we are taking this as the female plant and this one as male plant. We can show it in the checkerboard like this or peanut square. Here the gamete, capital T, small y. The other one is small t and small y. Two gametes, capital T, capital T, capital Y, small y. These two, capital T and small y, this is capital Y, small y, capital T, small t and small y, small y. These two, small t, small y, capital T, small t and small y. These two are small t, capital Y and small y. These two, small t and small y. Tall and green. This is tall and green. This is tall and green. Remaining, this is tall yellow. Tall and green. Tall yellow, tall and yellow. This is dwarf yellow, and this one is dwarf and green. The question is, tall and green, how many? Here are 8 progenies. Out of that 8 progenies, tall and green, 1, 2 and 3, 3 by 8, tall green. Now, the second question, that is dwarf and green, is 1 by 8. Dwarf and green is only 1 by 8. So, this is the answer for this particular question. Now, think it over, the given question, and find out the answer. You are given tall pea plant with yellow seeds whose genotypes are unknown. How would you find the genotype of these plants? Explain with the help of Punnett square. So, try to find out the answer and submit on the next session. Thank you.